Hi, my name's Meaghan Anderson. I'm an extension field agronomist with Iowa State University. And this spring, unlike many springs, we have been really dry. And so in this video, we're actually going to show the effect of different planting depths on soybeans when they're planted into these drier conditions that we saw this spring. So let's see, last Thursday, we planted beans at a few different depths here out at our field extension education lab. And we're out here 8 days out from that original planting date, and we are checking on how these beans are doing. So the deepest beans we planted were what, like 2.5 inches in the ground or so, which is probably, depending on who you ask, is as deep or even deeper than we would ever suggest that you go, right? That's like the deepest beans are ever gonna be in the ground. And you can see here that they're already on their way. They started their germination process, right? So initially they're gonna imbibe some water, they suck up that water and they grow to quite a bit larger than their original size. And then that radical, that root starts to exit the plant, and then the hypocotyl starts to lengthen on them. And so you can see these are already well into that germination process. Actually, this one is quite a bit further along even than that other. So there is some variability even at that depth as to when they got started germinating. But let's look at some of the shallower depths and see how they're doing too. All right. So these beans were a little bit shallower. They were more like maybe 1¾ inches or a couple inches in the ground, perhaps. Oops, that one's broken. So if you take a look at these, you can dig it out and see that these are just, they're not quite as far along as those other ones were, but they're pretty close. So they were obviously in some moisture last week as well. And you can see that that radicals started, and then that hypocotyl has started to lengthen. So basically that stem, and that's what's actually gonna pull, right? So this whole seed is gonna be pulled above the ground and be the first leaves on the plant. And so that's the concern with planting these too deep, is that this plant has to have enough energy coming from that seed to be able to actually pull it and flip those leaves up above the ground. So if we plant those beans too deep, we're gonna be worried that it won't actually be able to lengthen out this hypocotyl enough and then be able to yank those beans above ground. So the big concern that we had this spring was with planting beans too shallow, or planting them into dry dirt, and what's gonna happen to those soybeans. Because if we lay beans into dry soil and there's no moisture there, we risk basically just having to wait for that rainfall for those beans to be able to imbibe water and start the germination process. And you can see here that these beans were actually really shallow in the ground, and they, we were pretty pleased. They actually got a rainfall, Sunday night, so just a few days after planting. So they were planted on Thursday, and you can see that they have since started that germination process because they got a little bit of moisture on them. So that radical is out of the seed here, but it doesn't look like that hypocotyl is really lengthening yet to pull them above ground. So the concern that we have this spring, and we typically don't have this, is that these beans, they were sitting in dry dirt. We weren't sure when they would get moisture. And now they have moisture, enough so to germinate. But you can see here that they're in pretty powdery soil still themselves. So that root needs to get down into some good moisture in order to continue being able to grow. I don't think we're gonna have any issues here, but we're gonna keep an eye on them and we'll keep you updated on it for sure. Oh no, Warren, you've got grubs. Sorry.
Oh yeah, you do.
Gross.